Morning, everybody. It is November 6th, Saturday. I'm going to do this and then get my stuff together and then take a nice leisurely drive to Santa Barbara for our immediate family gig tonight at the Libero Theater. So excited to be, you know, got two shows in a row. We do the Libero tonight and then the Canyon Club tomorrow night in Agoura. And then next week, end of the week, we head off to the East Coast and start our run back there. It's so nice to be playing in front of an audience again. And had a great time yesterday doing two episodes of the Kelly Clarkson show. The band is so good on that show. We have such a great time together. It's a real natural fit. So I really appreciate the fact that when the seat's empty for any time, that I'm one of the people that gets the call to come down and fill in. So it was great. Kelly's just an absolute hoot, and she sang on the first episode. She sang "You've Got a Friend," and I talked to her on the show a little bit about, you know, why it was my request for her to sing that. And I talked about having recorded the original with James while Carol was actually in the band, and it was just before she recorded it on Tapestry, and the fact that a week ago Carol was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and Russ and Cooch and I went back with her and played "You've Got a Friend," so it felt like kind of a natural. And then for the second show, I threw out "Another Day in Paradise," Phil Collins, and she sang that. I mean, she's just a great stylist. She's got some amazing pipes. She's still one of the best singers that's ever come off of those format shows. And when she was American Idol, but boy, when she opens her mouth, boy, she's got it. And she's covered on this Kelly-oke is where she does it. We, you know, do cut down versions of the songs. I think she's done like 400 of these now, and she nails all of them. She's something else, and just a cool vibe. She's really great, and it's a great team on that show. The whole staff and crew and stuff are really cool people. So I had a great time yesterday. It was a long day, but a long day doing good things is not a bad thing. Long day doing crap sucks, but that's a whole other discussion. So I'm going to go ahead and do a little music today for you. I'm going to revisit an artist who I visited many, many, many videos ago, going after some other material that we did together, and show you that. And that is the wonderful Rita Coolidge. I got to do so much work with Rita back in the day, and then when she was with Kris Kristofferson, when they were a couple, I did the Rita and Kris albums. And then I did work with Kris individually also. But this album, I've got my CN right here. Okay, what do we got here? This album is called All About Rita Coolidge. I think it's a compilation from 1979, and it was produced by David Anderley, who I dearly miss. David was one of the best producers I ever worked with. His demeanor in the studio and his contributions were just perfect. You know, some producers really kind of step all over the place and don't really give, you know, that's like they say, man, we couldn't do this without you. You're the perfect person. And the minute you pick up your instrument, they're telling you what to do. And, oh, I gotta do this. And David was just a joy to work with. And when he finally stopped producing, he went back to his true gift, which was as a painter. And his paintings were absolutely beautiful. I love David very much. I miss him. One of the musicians on this project also, I've mentioned his name before, but never really went into it, was a guitarist named Jerry McGee. I did a lot of records with Jerry, and he was, you know, of like the Wrecking Crew company. And he worked with he was a member of the Ventures, and they worked in Japan all the time. And Jerry was actually 81 years old. He was in Japan doing a solo tour and died on the course of the tour. But during the course of his career, he played with Bobby Darin and the Everly Brothers and Elvis and Ricky Nelson and Eric Clapton, Delaney and Bonnie, Kristofferson. I mean, it's unbelievable. Played on the Monkees records. I mean, this guy was an amazing musician. So the first song I'm going to play for you right now is called Whiskey Whiskey, And it's the band on this is myself, Rita, of course, has vocals on everything. Myself, Bernie Ledden on guitar. And Bernie was in one of the first incarnations of the Eagles. The great Al Perkins on pedal steel, Mike Utley on keyboards. And Mike has been like the musical director for Jimmy Buffett for years. And we did all of the Christofferson stuff together and all of Rita's stuff. And Mike's a wonderful, wonderful keyboard player. Russ Kunkel on drums on this, and Chris Christofferson doing background vocals. So here's Whiskey Whiskey. Always been a fan of Rita's singing. I mean, it's very in the world of Peggy Lee. There's that kind of thing in it. And Diana Krall ended up also it, more in a jazz idiom, but that same kind of a timbre in the voice. And the thing, once again, that was just great about making these records was most all the musicians were on the sessions. So we were able to create music together, not piecemealing it and, you know, me just doing a bass part and a drummer then doing a drum part and then where you were confined to your part, where when we did these things, we talked about things, we worked parts out, and it was just a pretty amazing, wonderful time to be making music. Next song I'm going to do is called Mama Lou, and it's Rita on vocals and myself on bass, Sammy Creason on drums, who did a lot of work with Rita and Chris, Dean Parks and Jerry McGee on guitar, Al Perkins on steel, Mike Utley on keyboards, Booker T. Jones of Booker T. and the MGs on piano, Milt Holland on vibes, Nick DeCaro on accordion, Gib Gilbo on fiddle, Herb Peterson on banjo, Jeffrey Levin on dobro, Bobby Hall on percussion, and the background vocals on this were Jennifer Warren, Brooks Honeycutt, Rita Bodine, Linda Dillard, Kenny Edwards, Andrew Gold, Donna Weiss, and Priscilla Jones. It's a hell of a lineup on this song. So here we go. This is Mama Lou.
Nighttime often finds me in the street and firm in a tavern made alone as Eddie and Flo's golden bird. Where an old gold to the lady with a big bamboo fan plays piano and sings.
It's like really just really fun, great music just to listen to and to play. kind of nice out. I might listen to some of that as I'm driving up to Santa Barbara today. Just chill out and close my eyes and relax. No, I don't think so, not while driving. Next song I want to do is Desperado's Waiting for the Train, and it's pretty much the same lineup as the previous song when I looked at the credits on that. So here we go, Desperado's Waiting for the Train.
I'd sing the Red River Valley. You'd sit in the kitchen and cry. And run his fingers through 70 years of living. When the Lord is every well I drill gone dry. We were friends. Me and this old man, like desperados waiting for the train. Desperados waiting for the train. He's a drifter and a driller of old wells. An old school man. Taught me how to drive his car when he's too drunk to. When he'd wink and waste some money on the girls. Our life was like some old western movie, like desperados waiting for the train. The Green Frog Cafe. There were old men with beer guts and dominoes, lying about their lives while they played. I was just a kid, they all called his sidekick. I guess the Desperados waiting for the stains all down his chin. To me, he's one of the heroes of this country. So why is he all dressed up like that old man? Breaking beer, playing moon in 42, like a desperado. Just closed their eyes and dreamed a supper kitchen and sang another verse to that old song. Come on, Jack, I swear this time it's coming. We're desperados waiting for the train. Just desperados waiting for the train.
still think one of the things I enjoy the most about this period of recording was it was pre-click. So we would just count the tune off and we would play it. And sometimes if you wanted to check it, the end might be a little faster than where it started or a little slower, or the, you know, verses would be one tempo, might pick up just a touch in the chorus or do a little something extra in the bridge. But it was so organic. It was just everybody was in the moment together. And I'm not dumping on click, but there are times when you just wish they weren't using it so that you could actually let the song have some breathing qualities to it. But generally, that's not the nature of the beast at this point. One last song, and then I'm going to get ready to head to Santa Barbara. This is called Southern Lady. And on this one, it's, you know, of course, Rita singing. Myself, Mike Utley on piano and organ, Jerry McGee on guitar, Sammy Creason on drums, and Bobby Hall on percussion. And the background vocalists on this are the great, it's Clyde King, Vanetta Fields, and Shirley Matthews. So this is Southern Lady. Here we go. So that album is all about Rita Coolidge from 1979. And I believe it's, you know, pretty much a compilation of a lot of projects that we did before, but a lot of really good songs on this, you know, and I just love what she does. And I loved working with David Anderley as a producer. So it was really cool. So I'm going to pack it in here and get myself together. I'm going to load a pile of books in my car and going to have those at the gig tonight. I sold a bunch of them at the Coach House, which was fantastic. I was really thrilled. So, you know, I sat around after the show signing books and hopefully be able to do the same for the next two shows here. And then I have a bunch of them back east that I'll have out there on the road with me. And so it's all going good and excited. Just want everybody to stay safe. I'm just going to, as always, just say thank you to all of the people who really are working hard. I was looking at the staff of Kelly Clarkson's show. I mean, everybody's masked. They have to have vax proof and everything. And everybody did it. And the show runs flawlessly. It's great. And nobody feels weird or anything like that. They don't feel they're being infringed upon. They just want to do their jobs and be safe. Done. But thank you, especially to people in healthcare. It's a tough gig at this point, knowing that you're dealing with a lot of people that don't have to be under your care. It's their choice not to do it, and then they're paying the price, and then you end up paying the price also with them. But I'll be back tomorrow with some more music. It's fun going back and finding artists that I did many videos ago and finding more stuff that I did with them to present, because a lot of artists I've done multiple albums with. Yumi Matsutoya in Japan, I've done like 20 some albums with her over the years. Many of these artists, I see their name come up and I'm going, God, I did like a dozen albums with that person. And it's weird to be like 700, you know, going on 800 videos and knowing I'm just kind of touching, you know, at the tip of the iceberg still at this point. And it kind of blows my mind at times because I never really think about what I've done. I just think about what am I going to be doing. And off and running. So take good care, be safe. Anybody who maybe is going to be there tonight, I look forward to saying hi and meeting you. And the same tomorrow night at the Canyon Club. It should be fun. I know there's going to be clubhouse members going to be there, and that's going to be cool. I love hooking up with you. So have a great day, and we will talk later. Okay, bye-bye.